Hello everybody, welcome to Children's Church. I hope you got to enjoy the lovely sunshine this week and that you're ready now to learn from God's Word. So let's remember to pray for the Harvey family, our missionaries in Exeter. Let's pray for them now. Lord, thank you so much for this beautiful day. Lord, I thank you for all the boys and girls that are listening. And Lord, we'd like to bring before you the Harvey family in Exeter. Please, Lord, send them helpers to help out in various different things at church that they need. They need helpers for children's church to play the piano, and they would love for more souls to be saved. And Lord, we also want to pray for Pastor Anita in the States. Keep them safe, Lord. And we look forward to seeing them in a few weeks. And Lord, help us to learn from your word today as we continue our study in the book of Acts. And we pray for all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, before we start our lesson, let's listen to a song called Jesus Loves the Little Children. You can try to sing along. Now, we have been studying the book of Acts and we've been learning how God's power changes lives. We have seen believers boldly teach others about Jesus, not fearing being imprisoned or harmed as a result. In our last lesson, we saw how Jesus changed the life of Saul. He once persecuted people who believed in Jesus. And after he was saved, he began boldly sharing the good news with others. God saved Saul from his sins when he believed in the Lord Jesus Christ. And God had a job he was preparing Saul to do. Today we're going to look at Acts chapter 9 and we'll be looking at verses 32 to 43. So if you have your Bibles, you can get them ready or we'll show some verses on the screen as well. Now this instrument is a tin whistle. Now, I'm sure most of you would have seen a tin whistle before, but if you haven't, this is what it looks like. I used to actually play the tin whistle when I was in school, but I haven't practiced in a very long time. Now, to make music, you have to blow air through the mouthpiece and place your fingers over the different holes and to make a tune. Now, if I put my fingers on the holes and just move them up and down, that's not going to make any music because I need to also have air flowing through the instrument. And without the air flowing through, it doesn't work as a musical instrument. Every believer is an instrument that God uses for his purposes. When a believer is saved, God the Holy Spirit comes inside a person and fills them with his power. And this way, God enables the believer to function for the purposes that he has created. At the end of our last lesson about Saul, we learned that he was sent to Tarsus. I'll just remind you of those verses here. Acts 9, 30 and 31. Which, when the brethren knew, they brought him down to Caesarea and sent him forth to Tarsus. Remember that they found out that there was people planning to kill Saul, so they sent him down in a basket down the side of the wall, and they sent him off to Tarsus to keep him safe. Then had the churches rest throughout all Judea and Galilee and Samaria, and were edified, and walking in the fear of the Lord and in the comfort of the Holy Ghost were multiplied. While Saul is in Tarsus, many people who have studied scriptures believe that God was using that time to teach Saul and prepare him for the work that God had chosen him to do. Now let's have a look at Acts 9:32. And it came to pass, as Peter passed throughout all quarters, he came down also to the saints which dwelt at Lydda. So we've moved from Saul, and we're going to focus on Peter now. So Peter is traveling throughout the country. He's visiting believers and encouraging them. And along his travels, he comes to a place called Lydda. And you can see there, it's not too far from Jerusalem. Now, who is he visiting in Lydda? The verse says he's visiting the saints. What are saints? Well, when I was younger, I used to think that saints were perfect people, holy people, people who would never made a mistake in their lives. But actually, saints are people who are believers. Anyone who places their faith in Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of their sins is a saint. Peter was traveling around, visiting believers and encouraging them, and he arrives at this place called Lydda. In verse 33, we meet Aeneas. And there he found a certain man named Aeneas, which had kept his bed 8 years and was sick of the palsy. He was bedridden. That meant that he could not get up and move around. He was sick of the palsy. This means that his muscles were paralyzed and not able to move. And he had been this way for 8 years. That's a long time. If you can get up and move about, you should thank God every day. We take it for granted, all the things that we can do. And it is hard for us to imagine not being able to walk properly, for example, like this man. Let's look at the next verse. And Peter said unto him, Aeneas, Jesus Christ maketh thee whole. Arise and make thy bed. And he arose immediately. As soon as Peter spoke those words, Aeneas got up. Wow. Acts 9:35 says, And all that dwelt at Lydda and Saron saw him and turned to the Lord. A miracle took place in Aeneas' life. A miracle is something only God can do. The words Peter spoke pointed to the one who had the power to heal Aeneas. Peter didn't say, I am the apostle Peter, and by my authority and power, I heal you. No, he knew that only Jesus Christ had the authority and power to heal. God used Peter as his instrument to speak to Aeneas and offer him the gift of healing. When the people living in Lydda and Saron saw that Aeneas was healed, they turned to the Lord. When believers use their gifts, and in this example, when Peter used the gifts that God had given him, others were able to see God's work and his power and believed in him. As Peter continues to visit with the saints in Lydda, there is a believer named Tabitha who lives in Joppa. You can see here on the map, Joppa is by the coast, and it also is not too far from Lydda. Tabitha's name is translated as Dorcas in the Greek. Let's read how Tabitha used her gifts to serve the Lord. Acts 9:36. Now there was at Joppa a certain disciple named Tabitha, which by interpretation is called Dorcas. This woman was full of good works and alms deeds which she did. The New Testament was written in Greek, and Tabitha's name in Greek is Dorcas. I have a brother, and his name is John. In Irish, his name would be Sean, but in Old Irish, it would be Owen. So Tabitha, or Dorcas, was full of good works, the Bible says, and alms deeds. What does that mean? Well, she was always helping out and doing good, doing good for others. And almsdeeds is when you give things to others that are in need. So this woman was a very loving and charitable woman. Acts 9:37. And it came to pass in those days that she was sick and died, whom when they had washed, they laid her in an upper chamber. Tabitha became sick and died. Her body was washed and prepared and placed in a room upstairs. The people were very upset. They loved Tabitha, this kind and giving woman. Acts 9:38. And forasmuch as Lydda was nigh to Joppa, and the disciples had heard that Peter was there, they sent unto him two men, desiring that he would not delay to come to them. So the believers in Joppa, they heard that Peter was nearby in Lydda. So they sent two men with a message for him to come as quick as he could to Tabitha's house. Peter returned to Joppa with the two men and went upstairs to the room where Tabitha's body was placed. While Tabitha was alive, she always showed kindness and helped others. She helped poor widows by making them clothes. When Peter was in the room, the widows were crying and showing him the clothes that Tabitha had made while she was still alive. Acts 9:40. But Peter put them all forth and kneeled down and prayed, and turning him to the body said, Tabitha, arise. And she opened her eyes, and when she saw Peter, she sat up. So Peter sends everyone out of the room. Once again, God used Peter as his instrument to perform a powerful miracle. Peter could not raise a person from the dead in his own strength. He could only raise Tabitha because God, the Holy Spirit, lived inside of him. Remember, Peter is the instrument that God is using. Acts 9:41. And he gave her his hand and lifted her up, and when he had called the saints and widows, presented her alive. And Acts 9:42 says, and it was known throughout all Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. As we saw with Aeneas' healing, when people in Joppa heard that Tabitha was raised from the dead, many believed in Jesus. Peter and Tabitha both used the gifts that God had given them to serve him. If you are a believer, God has given you gifts to use to serve him. Are you using your gifts to serve Jesus? Do you need to get up and begin serving him today? Are you allowing fear or distractions keeping you from serving Jesus? Maybe you're not sure how you can serve God. Pray and ask God to help you learn how you can serve him. If you have never been saved, you cannot please God or serve him. Let's look at Isaiah 64:6. But we are all as an unclean thing, and all our righteousnesses are as filthy rags, and we all do fade as a leaf. We can never be good enough to please God. Our righteousnesses are like filthy rags, and that is why Jesus died for your sin and my sin, and he rose again. God has a gift for you. The Bible says, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord, in Romans 6:23. So how do you receive a gift? Do you work for it? No. Suppose that you were very hungry and thirsty and you saw a table, and on this table was your favorite kind of food. It even had your favorite drink. It looks so good and you are so, so hungry. Now imagine that on this table with all this wonderful food, there was a card. On the card was a note that said it was just for you. Wow! Now wouldn't it be silly to walk all around that table and begin to wonder if it was truly yours? How do you receive a gift on the table? You take it. It is the same with God's gift of salvation. All the work has been done. Jesus died for you and rose again, and now you must choose to accept his gift. If you have never received God's gift of salvation, you can do it right now. Just bow your head and pray something like this in your own words. Dear God, I know I have sinned. I believe that Jesus died for my sin and rose again. I want to receive your gift of salvation right now. Please come into my life and save me. In Jesus' name, amen. If you pray that today, would you please let us know that you have decided to receive God's wonderful gift of salvation? We would love to help you grow to be more like Jesus. Let's listen to one more song before we go. Easter or Resurrection Sunday, it's coming up soon, and I'd like to tell you about this fun object lesson. So moms, dads, if you want to try this with your kids, send us an email and we can send you the recipe with the instructions, or you can also Google it. If you Google resurrection cookies, this is a great object lesson for the resurrection. There's only a couple of ingredients. And it's as you go through the recipe with the kids, you're going to teach them at each step all about the death and resurrection of Jesus. So if you're interested in that, just let us know. And here are the details if you want to get in touch. Our church email and the church phone number there. And to contact any of the children's church teachers, it's childrenchurchbbc@gmail.com. I hope to see you again next week, and we're going to find out what Peter gets up to in the next chapter. So I'll see you then.